Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel, Outdoor Pursuer. This is part two of the Fort Wayne bike trails, part one of the Rivergreenway. This particular trail runs both east to west, starting in New Haven, which is a smaller town on the outskirts of Fort Wayne, all the way to about downtown Fort Wayne. It continues on through to the west side of Fort Wayne, but at Rock Hill Park, it kind of transitions from being the River Greenway to another trail called Towpath Trail, and then just continues on out, again connecting with the Boyd Trails, which is on the west side, southwest side of Fort Wayne. But the River Greenway also runs north to south, and that'll be in part three and four. But part one and two are going to go, they're going to be the trail heading east to west. So you'll see in this trail, I actually wanted to start from downtown New Haven, but you can see at the time of this particular bike ride, there was construction going on the road that leads directly to downtown New Haven. So I started as close as I possibly could. You're probably about a half mile starting from downtown New Haven. But I wanted to do that and then go to downtown Fort Wayne and then continue on out. But you'll see at the end of this video too, we also run into a little bit of an obstacle there as well. But you'll have to watch to the end of the video to find out about that. This particular portion, the first portion of the River Greenway, actually holds a little bit of it means a lot more to me than some of the other sections of the trail, and that would be because at the height of COVID, at least in Fort Wayne area anyways, it would have been spring of 2020. A lot of areas were shut down, gyms were shut down. The only thing that you really could do was be outside in nature, which I love doing anyways, so it wasn't a big deal to me. But I spent a lot of time on this particular section of the trail, completing walks with both my mom and my sister. So that just kind of holds a special place in my heart. Maybe like a year since I'd been back to this particular portion of the trail, and getting on this bike ride, it just brought a lot of feelings back to me. So I just hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Speaking of, on that note too, so for this video, hopefully you'll see I went ahead and upgraded some of the equipment that I have. So You'll hopefully notice an improvement in the video quality as well as sound quality. So I purchased a new GoPro, and I updated the editing software that I use. So hopefully, I'll add this in for anybody that maybe cares, maybe doesn't, but anyways. Upgrading to the new GoPro, the old format that the GoPro, I was using a GoPro Hero 3 before, and the format that the videos are put in are, I hope I get this right, it's an H.264, which translates to MPG. Again, I'm hoping I get this right. It's just off the top of my head. But so that's for the GoPro 3. And then the GoPro 10, which the format that video that it records in is actually called an HVEC, or high, or it would be an H.265. And so I didn't know this at the time when I was recording. So I have a lot of I went ahead and updated the video software so that it could register and they were compatible together. So hopefully in Hopefully that translates into what you're watching now, and it's an enhanced experience for you guys. If not, you know, leave comments, questions, etc. Let me know what I can work on to improve these. But anyways, it's slightly enough of nerding out. I've rambled way too much, so I'm just gonna be quiet now, and you guys can enjoy the bike ride.
Thank you. I'm not sure which way I'm going. I think this way though. Thank you.
Thanks for watching, guys. That was the end of part two of the Fort Wayne Trails, but part one of the River Greenway. I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did, and you can kind of see the conundrum that we're at. So not only was there construction at the beginning of the trail, but then later on, I didn't know this, there's construction. Well, I did know this because I've been downtown and I know that they were working on this bridge, but I didn't realize, or maybe I did, but the construction intersects with the bike trail as well. So not a big deal. We'll just, instead of going smoothly through, we'll just start on the other side in the next video. But again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any suggestions on what you'd like to see next, any comments on what I can improve on, just leave those down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Click the little notification bell to know when I upload. Thanks, and I'll see you outdoors. So I'm happy this happened after I got to the point where I was going to cut the video off. But I still am kind of baffled at how it happened in the first place, so let me see if I can explain this. After I got to the bridge where I stopped for the cutoff, obviously I had to get back to where I started. So on my way back, I don't know if anybody else has ever had this happen to him, but so I got to crossing the other bridge that's a little bit further downtown, and you can see this, but you can't really tell what happened, so I'm going to see if I can explain it the best. Anyways, I was getting ready to cross the street. I had an opportunity, and so I picked up the bike by the handlebars, and when I did, the handlebars came out of where it connects with the front wheel. God, I don't know if you can call it, not really the steering, but anyways, it came out, and so handlebars detached from the bike. The bike stayed where it was. and this guy, that's slightly embarrassing, but anyways, so it was kind of interesting on the finishing up the rest of the ride back. The handlebars are not like, I could stick them back in, but they're not like screwed in, attached, whatever. So I'm like riding, I got the wheel straight, but my handlebars are turned completely sideways. Yeah, it was interesting. Anyways, eventually I got them so that they were in far enough and they stayed kind of put. But yeah, if that's happened to anybody else, go ahead and leave that in the comments, because that's never happened before. And it was a unique, interesting experience. So, thanks for watching.